The best way to explore a new city is to connect with the people living in it. Vibrant communities with stories untold. This is Next Stop Nebraska. Today on Next Stop, we're headed out west and taking the back roads to a quaint little place called Heartland Elk Guest Ranch. If you are looking for a place for you or your family to lose the technology and reconnect with nature, we'll look no further. This is Shane. He and his wife, Brenda, are the managers of the ranch, and they live on the property with their two boys.
We love the place. I mean, the Elk Ranch is just, it just draws you in once you're here and you kind of experience it all, and it just kind of keeps you here.
How many acres is this property then?
So there's 1,500 acres on the Elk Ranch now. The county road kind of splits us in half. So on the east side...
Is that the road that I came in
yep.
on? Okay.
On the east side of the road, it's more of our elk operation, and on the west side, it's the cabins and hiking trails and creek bottoms, and then we do wildlife viewing stuff and food plots and things like that on this side.
I need to show you how beautiful this is. Look at this. Look at this backdrop. This is what you can wake up to every morning that you stay here.
But the people are really starting to get the feel of why this place is special when there's nobody around. You get to experience the openness and solitude, and you know, it's great scenery. It's peaceful.
That makes a very good point. Those that like more of that solitude could come out here
yeah.
and just sit by the fire or read a book and be a part of nature.
We're trying to kind of gear this place that direction where it's a disconnect location.
It does force you to, one, connect with nature and just find like the peace within yourself. Even though people say they're not on their phones all the time or all that, when you have access, it's so easy to just quick check. This really does put in perspective, like, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
You can't be on your phone.
I walked around so I could look at the different cabins. There were only a handful of them, but each of them was different and had unique features. And Shane said that they stay busy and are booked up almost already all of next summer.
It's almost always return guests, because once they come here and they experience it, they want to bring other people here and they just want to do it with more of their family.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a really cool connection.
Shane and Brenda came to the area originally what was supposed to be just 6 months, but 11 years later, they're still here and loving it.
It's a neat opportunity for me to have my family here. They love it. What better place for a little boy to grow up? It's a part of Nebraska that people don't even realize is here. Once you slow down here and you kind of get to see what this involves, like right in this area, it's amazing.
After a lovely chat with Shane, I cozied up next to the fire so I could get some work done. Took the time to write a nice thank you note for a wonderful stay, but now it's lights out for me so I can get on the road to my next stop.